Welcome back to the Great Day Kitchen. This morning we are joined by nutritional expert Ashley Reinke.
All right, Ashley, what's on the menu this break? This looks amazing.
Okay, so this is a really fun rendition of a vegan lobster roll.
Okay.
And we've all maybe tried a lobster roll, and it's hard to come up with something that is going to compare quite to that.
Yeah.
But this is a great way to still get the taste and the texture and kind of that fun novelty of eating something like a lobster roll in these warmer months.
And a little less expensive.
And we're going to incorporate some of those things we love in the nutrition world, some great vegetables.
Sure.
So we are going to get started by slicing hearts of palm into oblique shapes in these kind of weird triangle shapes. You can just have fun with it. But hearts of palm is actually going to be what makes up our quote unquote lobster meat.
Sure.
So that's all you really have to do. Now, do you know where the heart of palm comes from?
I'm guessing the center.
How about the country or the or the origin?
Okay, Saudi Arabia.
Close, but try
New York. No.
How about starts with a Osta and ends with a Rika?
what was it? Starts with a what?
Starts with a Osta, ends with a Rika.
Costa Rica.
There we go.
Which is a beautiful place.
A beautiful place indeed. So they grow kind of on the palm trees there, and I had no idea really where they came from. I'm not an arborist, and kind of had to ask one of my professors who's in botany, and I was like, didn't want to admit, hey, where does this heart of palm come from? We all see it in the grocery store, but where does it actually come from? So I was like, asking for a friend, where does this come from? And yeah, sure enough, it is a, you know, it's the
which
inner.
Which is a little closer than Saudi Arabia.
Exactly, and apparently there are some in Florida as well. So you're just going to slice these on up. The nice thing that they also offer is these are really high in fiber. So
yeah, they're crunchy.
They're crunchy. Yeah. And it's going to have some of those extra nutritional benefits.
Yeah,
that's great.
Yeah, so I'm just going to go ahead and add these to a bowl. Now, what are some of your favorite barbecue foods over the summertime?
Oh, I'll tell you what, I'm a hamburger kind of guy.
Oh, okay.
Love good burgers.
Okay, how about yourself?
I'm a steak kind of guy. But, you know, I can't eat shellfish, so this is a great cheat for me. Because this is something that I could eat.
Sure.
This is a great cheat in that case. And again, this is a way to kind of disguise some vegetables into your children's diets, too. And you can use this as a chicken salad substitute, or you can put it in a sandwich wrap or anything like that. So it's a versatile recipe. I am just kind of using my hands here, clean hands in the kitchen as always.
Absolutely.
But sometimes, you know, your hands really are your best tools. So don't be afraid to get in there and get a little dirty.
That's well, if you don't get dirty in the kitchen, forget it. You know what I mean? You're really not doing the job. You know what I mean?
What's the fun? What's the fun if you can't play around a little bit? So now that we've got these in here, do you want to go ahead and add those minced celery? There we go.
Okay, we're in there.
So that's the celery that we've added in. I'm going to go ahead and stir that on up.
Okay.
I'm just going to slice up a few pieces of cucumber.
Beautiful.
Real quick. You just need a couple. So here we go. Get that crisp and that color that we love. Perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Then over here, we've got fresh dill. Fresh dill is really going to give you that great aroma.
Yeah.
So we're going to just put all of that in there. And then we've got some Old Bay seasoning. It's going to give it that spicy kick. You can already see how this is coming together.
Oh, I like it. I like it already.
All right. And then we have got our vegan mayonnaise. And all we need for here, I'm going to just borrow this real quick. All you need is about 2 to 3 tablespoons, maybe even less.
Okay.
So just a little bit. This is plant-based again. So we're able to switch out a lot of those saturated fats for unsaturated fats. And see how as we stir this, it's really all starting to come together. And it almost looks like an egg salad, too.
It really does. It really does, yeah.
Yeah, so, you know, you don't have to choose anymore. You can have the best of both worlds. You can enjoy those flavors, but then you also don't have to worry about, you know, getting too much cholesterol or too much saturated fat in any of your meals.
You need a little salt and
pepper. A little bit of salt and pepper, because we need that, you know, salt and pepper shake. Salt and pepper shake.
Hoochie-coochie.
It's summertime. You have to dance when you
cook.
I hope someone told you that. It's the unwritten rule of culinary chefs everywhere. When it's summertime, you dance while you cook. Okay, so now we're just going to sprinkle in a little bit of arugula to give it a crunch.
It always sounds like an old-timey horn. Arugula! Get out of the way, I'm coming. Arugula!
That's great. I always like those words that when you say them, they make you smile.
Yeah.
And I think arugula is on there. You know, celery, I like that one too.
Celery, that's good.
And then what you can do with this too is you can top it with some fresh chives.
Sure.
Or
ketchup. No, just kidding. Just kidding. I would never do that.
I'm telling you, this is pretty tasty with that, with all those fresh herbs in there. And then, like any good lobster roll, you got to have a little bit of lemon. Exactly.
It just has that little zinger to it.
Yeah, it gives it that fresh taste.
Well, that looks beautiful.
So voila. Yeah. And just like that, you can serve these up at your next barbecue. Yeah. Your kids can enjoy them.
Yeah. Well, can I take a quick bite?
Absolutely. Let me give you this one.
Because with all that trouble, my goodness.
Yes.
You have customers waiting.
And let me see if I, I don't have a fork anywhere.
Don't worry about it.
Okay. This is the moment we're waiting for.
Yeah.
Man, this is good. The flavor is unbelievable.
I'm really happy to hear that.
The texture and the flavor, great. Just great. Delicious.
I've been serving them to my non-vegan vegetarian family members and friends, and they've all given me the same unanimous agreement. So I highly recommend this dish. You can serve it on the side. You can put it into a wrap. Yeah. You can put it into a sandwich.
All right. We're going to come back in the next break and work on something else.
Yes, we are.
And we've got the full recipe. Just go to our Great Day tab and click on the kitchen tab from the drop-down menu.